Deputy Adams.
Report from Dr. Jeffrey Shannon, the State Special Rapporteur for Child Protection, on the use by Garda Síochána of Section 12 of the Child Care Act 1991, and the details which emerged on last night's RT Investigates programme, as you have acknowledged, are both frightening and scandalous. And according to Dr. Shannon, cooperation between Tuzla and Garda Síochána, and I quote, is overwhelmingly inadequate. He makes 17 recommendations. That some of these are so basic, that some of these are just so much common sense, begs the question, why weren't they put in place long before this? For example, the need for all Gardaí to undergo diversity training, or the need for interagency cooperation. But the big failures in the system are the lack of capacity, the absence of an out-of-hours service, and Tuzla's reliance on private foster care services. And Dr. Shannon says that vulnerable children, and I quote again, are getting an inferior service. He also says, and again I quote him, it's absolutely scandalous that some of these private services refuse to take children with challenging behaviour. Now, Taoiseach, I cannot think of a more telling indictment of the state's child protection services than the charge that vulnerable children are getting an inferior service. I'm very certain that you are upset by this, but I'm sure you'll also accept that expressions of regret just won't cut it anymore. The child protection system is broken, and your government is charged with fixing it. So I'm calling upon you to ensure that Dr. Shannon's 17 recommendations are implemented in full, and that this is done immediately. Citizens will be shocked to hear that child protection training for Gardaí is basically non-existent, that the lack of cooperation between Tuzla, contrary to what you have said, that there's strategic meetings at a senior level, that the lack of cooperation, according to this report, between Tuzla and the Gardaí is simply breathtaking. And last week we discussed the crisis in child and adolescent mental health services. This week it's a new set of scandals. What will be next week or the week after? And this is not the first set of revelations about Tuzla. It's the duty of your government to change that reality. The CEO of Tuzla, Fred McBride, in Tuzla must be held accountable. He should come forward to the Oireachtas Committee on Children and Youth Affairs. Minister Saponi should come before the Dáil as quickly as possible to give the government's response to this damning report. And the initial, let's just record this, response of Tuzla, apparently attempting to undermine Dr. Shannon, is totally and absolutely unacceptable. And that's the knee-jerk reaction of most of the system here when it gets criticism, whether it gets it from a whistleblower or from the Special Rapporteur for Children. It's to undermine what it's been criticised for. So my questions are very simple. One, will you fully commit to ensuring 24 access to social workers throughout this state as an urgent priority? 70% of the children taken in under Section 12 were cases the Gardaí were already aware of, so will you ensure that these cases are immediately followed up on to ensure the welfare of these children, including the child and the children at the centre of the RT Investigates programme? And will you initiate a whole government response, not just the minister responsible, but a whole government response to this scandal, including perhaps an audit like that carried out by Dr. Shannon, being conducted across the entire child protection system?
Taoiseach.
Well, I can't disagree with the central issue of Deputy Adams's comments here. This has to be about accountability and not about zero accountability. The Child and Family Agency was set up for a particular purpose, and set up, as I said, as part of the response of government to placing children and children's voices at the centre of Irish society, with a, as I said, a senior ministry, a department dedicated directly to children, a referendum on children's rights, and pieces of legislation dealing from sexual abuse to marriage equality, covering issues of family and children. And there's obviously Dr. Shannon's report speaks for itself. It's a very good report. It is a damning report. It's a very clear report. He's made 17 recommendations. These must and will be followed through. Minister Zappone is to meet with the Taoiseach, Minister Fitzgerald, in respect of the issue here of communication between Tuisle and the Garda Síochána. Section 12 of the Child Care Act of 1991 is an essential mechanism, as you're well aware, which the Gardaí performs its child protection function, and it's only used as a measure of last resort. And the Commissioner for the Gardaí will have to respond to the issue of the report in respect of the training and training for diversity of Gardaí, also in respect of the pulse system, and in relation to the deficiencies identified therein. Deputies will recall that the government has already dedicated substantial resources for investment in Garda IT infrastructure, and a total of $330 million was provided by 2016 and 2021, or to be provided, including $205 million in the capital plan. So members of the House will appreciate that the design, the commissioning and the delivery of such a large-scale IT project takes time and obviously has to be got right in the first place. And the report comments on the deficiencies in child protection training for Gardaí, and they're very concerning, Deputy Adams, very concerning, and they need to be seriously addressed. So while the design of course provision is a matter for the Garda Commissioner of the first instance, I am advised that the current Garda Student and Probationer Training Programme incorporates modules including issues such as sexual assault and the Children First Guidelines. The extent to which the existing training programme should be expanded or amended on foot of Dr. Shannon's recommendations will need to be addressed by the Garda Commissioner and the Gardaí in their response to his report. So while acknowledging the serious issues raised for an Garda Síochána in the report, it is worth noting that there have been a number of important developments in Garda structures, including the establishment of the Garda National Protective Services Bureau, the creation of the Divisional Protected Services Units, and I am advised that it is also proposed to create a National Child Protection Unit also within the Garda Síochána. So some things are happening. My answer to your question is, will you see that this gets a full of government response? The answer to that question is yes.
Thank you.
Will we undertake to fulfil the 17 recommendations of Dr. Shannon? The answer to that question is also yes.
Deputy Adams.
Well, I thank you for your answer. And what we need now is results, Taoiseach. In 2012, the people of this state voted to enshrine children's rights in the Constitution. Sinn Féin and others canvassed on that. I met many, many, many people who were sceptical. And they were sceptical because they didn't trust the state. And, you know, if the Constitution is of any value to these children, then the government has to acknowledge that it's failing these children and failing our constitutional obligations to them. And I understand that the issues involved here go back a long time. You inherited this problem. You didn't create this problem. In the past, this state outsourced its responsibilities to churches, to religious orders, and to other institutions. And that clearly is no longer acceptable, and you played your part in that. And popular outrage is the guarantee that that will never happen again. But we shouldn't lose our sense of popular outrage. Outsourcing the responsibility for children, particularly vulnerable children, but to any child, to profit or to private for-profit companies should be equally unacceptable. We warned at the time that Tuisle was established that without adequate resources, without capacity, without a change of culture, the initiative would fail. So our child protection system is broken. It's essentially dysfunctional. I do welcome your straightforward answer to my questions, but if we're not to be back here next year, or the year after, or someone else instead of me, or someone else instead of you, look at another report like this, then you need to initiate that full government response that you've committed to and a complete overhaul of the children protection system.
Thank you, Deputy Taoiseach, to conclude.
Thanks, Deputy Albers. I didn't have time to say it the last time, but the Commissioner's Modernisation and Renewal Programme from 2016 to 2021 and the policing plan for this year, 2017, contain a commitment to implementing a new Garda diversity and inclusion strategy. And I understand that that's expected to be finalised shortly, Deputy Adams. I'm advised that all new Garda strategy will embrace the recommendation from the Children's Ombudsman arising from its review of the manner in which the Garda Síochána invoked its powers under Section 12 of the Child Care Act of 1991 in relation to two Roma children, which was an issue of national public discussion and concern some time ago. As part of this work, the Garda Síochána are committed to further training their workforce to develop their cultural competence in interacting with minority communities. So let me finally say to you that insofar as my tenure continues here, I will see to it that this is initiated in respect of children. We've done so much in terms of preparations that one of the central features of the child strategy issue has been the setting up of the child and family agency Thusla. We want to see that is enabled to do its work properly, and that, as I said to Deputy Martin, the central issue here is about the protection of children, not the protection of jobs or the protection of a structure. And I'll see that happens.
Thank you, Taoiseach.